Hollywood. The Jack Benny Program. With Jack's special guest, the Lettermen.
Thank you very, very much, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the show. You know, it is so gratifying to come out to such a wonderful reception. And it's so nice to know that I'm playing to an audience who can read. I remember once we did a show for a group of tourists from Tibet. I came out, he put up the sign, they thought it was a fire and ran out of the building. Remember, this happened once when I had an American audience, too. I don't know why. But anyway, these things don't bother me, applause or laughter, because when you've been in show business, you know that you... Dennis, come here.
Oh, hello, Mr. Benny.
Hello, hello. Listen.
Yeah.
I mean, what are you doing here? What did you bring these things out here for?
Oh, I need the scenery for the song I'm gonna sing.
The song? What song?
Yeah, I'm gonna sing The Last Time I Saw Paris.
Dennis, come here, kid. I wanna ask you something. I know I shouldn't ask this. I know it. What connection can there possibly be with The Last Time I Saw Paris and you sitting here in front of a Western set over a campfire?
I'm cooking crepes, Suzette.
Dennis, come here. You went through a lot of trouble for nothing because you're not singing a song. I've hired three fellas, a trio, to sing today.
You mean I'm not gonna sing a song?
No, you're not.
Well, can I just stay out here and eat?
You can eat in your dressing room. Now, go ahead.
Okay.
You see, he gets applause without the sign. Oh, well. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce my guests. For tonight, the three young fellows whose recordings you are all familiar with, the Lettermen.
Love is a many splendored thing. It's the April rose that only grows in the early spring. Love is nature's way of giving a reason to be living, a golden crown that makes a man a king. And the world stood still. Then your fingers touched my silent heart and taught it how to sing. Yes, true. Thank you.
was very, very good.
Thank you very much.
Now, look, I must ask you something. Having gone into this business as a trio of singing, how did you happen to choose the name The Lettermen?
Well, you see, we were all in college together, and we were in athletics, and we all won our letters.
Oh, and that's why you call yourself the... You won your letters, yes. I see.
Uh-huh. We found that the extracurricular activities were the most fun of anything in college.
Yes, I would imagine, yes.
Didn't you find that true when you were in college, Mr. Benny?
Well, you see, I didn't get to go to college because at that time I had to work, you see, I couldn't go, yeah? Uh-huh.
But you must know what we're referring to because they have the same sort of activities in high school.
You did go to high school, didn't you?
Pardon?
I say you did go to high school, didn't you?
Well, no, I could have gone. I owned the building. Now, fellas, how about singing an encore, huh?
Sure. Hey, wait a minute. Hold it. What's going on here?
What do you mean, what's going on here? They're going to sing another number.
Oh, a fine thing. I never get to sing two songs.
Well, Dennis, if it'll make you happy, on next week's show, you see, I'll allow you to sing two songs.
Not for what you're paying me.
Look, Dennis.
I don't like the way I'm being treated on this show.
Dennis, look, it doesn't... It's my show. I'm the boss. What I say goes. They're going to sing another song, and you're not going to do anything about it.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
That's what you think.
Always threatening this guy.
Well, look, Mr. Benny, if Dennis is so upset, maybe we shouldn't sing.
Oh, listen, don't let him worry you. When I say you sing another song, you can sing it. He can't do anything to stop it. Now, go ahead. Sing your song.
As I listen for the whistle, I lie awake and wait. Wish the railroad didn't run so near, 'cause the rattle and the clatter of that old fast freight keeps making music in my ear. Go bum again.
I've seen you do some awful things before, but this is the worst.
Oh, no, Mr. Benny. I didn't have anything to do with it. I don't know how it happened. Hey, Nick, not now. It's me.
Get off. You know, ladies and gentlemen, every time I see young fellas like the Lettermen who had a chance to go to college, it makes me realize how much I've missed. You know, it's the one thing I've always regretted. I can just imagine what it would have been like if I had gone to college. You know, the campus life. the football games. The chance to share a dormitory room with three or four other swell guys.
Gee, I hope we have as much fun this year as we had last year.
Yeah, me too.
Hey, what's with the extra bed?
Oh, they're so crowded this year, they're moving another fellow in with us.
Gee, I hope he's a nice guy.
Yeah. Hey, maybe that's him now. Come on in.
I guess I'm your new roommate. This is room 219, isn't it?
Yes. Yeah. Say, do you have your assignment slip? You know, sometimes they make mistakes.
Yes, here it is. That says 219, doesn't it?
That's it.
Well, in that case, welcome.
Thank you. I'm Bob, and that's Tony.
And I'm Jim.
Well, I'm Jack. I'm from Waukegan.
I didn't think he was from New York.
Well, shall we flip for the beds?
Oh, no. We've already got ours. That one's yours.
Oh.
You see, we were here last year.
Oh, you mean that you're not freshmen anymore, eh?
No, no, we're sophomores.
Oh, well, I guess I'm the youngest one in the room.
How old are you?
19.
You look about 39.
Oh, thanks. Well, oh, I know what I want is here.
Wow, look at that. And it doesn't even faze him.
Hey, look, man, you better knock that stuff off. There's a strict rule here against drinking.
Prune juice?
Prune juice?
Yeah, gee, it was a long trip on the train. Come on, hell, I'm going to unpack.
Yeah, let me help.
All right.
Hey, fellas, look at this.
Oh, major letter, huh?
Yeah, I was a cheerleader. Walking in high school. You know, wall walk, kiki, gam, gam, gam. Walkie, 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 gam. Wow! You know, it would be more exciting if I brought my pom-poms. I wanted to bring them, but my mother's having them bronze. Hey, fellas. I see you got all your pin-up pictures up there. Can I put mine up?
Sure, go ahead.
Okay. There we are. I want to put this up where I can see it. The last thing before I go to bed.
What's that?
The Denver Mint. Say, listen, fella, who's the professor in this class?
Oh, he's new here this year. I don't know his name, but he's supposed to be a great chemist.
Oh, is he?
Hey, here comes the professor now.
Straight, right from the outset, there will be no nonsense among the business in this class. You see, we're going to work every second due to the conditions of the world. We have to speed up the education. Yeah, we have to, these are times, of course, that we got to work, 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 work. So that when I call on you in this class, we make every second count. When I call on you, I want each one of you to stand up and tell us what the cutest thing what happened to you during your summer vacation.
Professor, this is a chemistry class, and I'd like to ask you a question.
Du lieber, that's what I like, a student with a little curiosity. What's on your mind, Liebchen?
How do you define the reciprocal of the logarithm of the hydrogen ion concentration of a solution?
And you would like me to answer that?
Yes.
Ah, I got an answer for you. You're expelled. Get out of here. One smart aleck in the crowd, huh? Well, now we get on with the experiment. You see here, we got a bunch of mess of test tubes here. And when we get out, I will need a volunteer to help me with the experiment.
I'll help you, Professor.
Only in the class 5 minutes, and already you're polishing the apple strudel, huh? Well, all right, come up, so. Formula to you, and you will follow it, see? But first, I want to show you that this experiment is on the up and up. You don't know me, I don't know you. Now we go, proceed. You take with a beaker here, and you take 1 cc, and you pour it in number 2. And now you take 3 cc's into number 4. And we take 5 cc's and you pour it into number 6. Six? That's seven. That's it. Now we will see if the experiment works. Shaved there. You know, always it was coming out, pop goes the weasel. You get an A.
I got A in chemistry.
No, in music, stupid. Now we will proceed with the lesson there, and I would like to ask you, what is the chemical composition of tourmaline? How about you?
I don't know.
You flunk. You over there.
I don't know.
You flunk. How about you? What's this loss with you? All I'm doing is asking a simple question, the chemical composition of tourmaline. Well, I'll try one more. You over there.
I'm sorry, Professor von Glasmeyer, but I don't know the answer.
Who cares? You get an A. You are a dumb cops. You have to work. I never saw such dumb cops in my life. You drive me aufgespielt. You drive me to drink, I tell you.
Who was putting in alcohol prune juice?
Now, before the class is over and the lesson is over, I would like to explain to you what we're going to do tomorrow, what our problem is tomorrow. We're going to discuss the components of the atomic bomb. Now, let us see. Over here, we have, of course, hydrogen.
Hydrogen itself is harmless. And over here, we have the nuclear substance. Which also in itself is harmless. But you see, when you get the two together,
you two, but I've had just about all I can stand of the Waukegan wizard.
You know, I never saw a guy work so many angles. You know, he makes pennants. He even crochets school emblems. He's got the hot dog concession at all the football games. You know, there's a nickel to be made. He's the guy that's...
I know what you mean.
I didn't mind it so much when he had his business activities on the outside.
But here he comes.
Reminding the store.
You know, I've heard of guys working their way through school, but Jack is ridiculous.
Hey, you guys, I got an idea. I think I know how we can get rid of Jack. This time he's gone too far.
Why, what happened?
Do you know what he's doing? He's getting answers to the tests and selling them. Oh! I heard him talking to some guy on the phone today, and he's going to meet him here tonight to sell him some answers.
That's terrible.
Well, I'll tell you what, let's catch him in the act, and then we'll report it, and he'll be expelled.
Yeah. Hey, that's a great idea. We'll get rid of that guy once and for all.
Hey, here he comes. Quick, turn off the lights. Well, and hide.
See, where are the answers? Oh, here they are. He wants the answers to tests 3 and 4. I hate to do this, but 25 bucks is 25 bucks. That's him now. Here we are. Here are the answers. Give me my 25 bucks.
Oh, yeah. Now he's got you. Hey.
Professor! Professor Krausmeier!
Well, it ain't Hopalong Cassidy.
You're the one who's buying the answers.
Well, certainly. The questions I know. Please stop. That's cheating. Now, don't forget, tomorrow you have the answers ready for test number 6 and 7.
I'll have them. I'll have them.
Good, good, good.
Look here. One word about this to anybody, and I give you X in everything. That's expel.
We'll be back in just a minute with the special guest, the Lettermen. But first...
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you all enjoyed the show. And now, once again, I'd like to bring out my guests, the Lettermen. Well, look, we did have a lot of fun, didn't we?
Oh, yes. Uh-huh.
Now, look at, how about singing that number now you tried to sing before?
Oh, okay.
Right. Go ahead.
Hear the whistle blow.
Good night, folks. I'll be seeing you soon. Dennis, I told you.